Are you trusting him? Are you standing upon his promise? Because when we do, here's what we'll discover, that there's no prayer too hard to be revealed. Also, we'll discover there's no person too hard for God to redeem. That there is no person too hard for God to redeem. God is in the redeeming business, is he not? You know, humanly speaking, if there was ever anybody who was ever beyond redemption, it would have been Saul of Tarsus of a day gone by. Remember Saul? The Bible says here is a man that was dead set and hell-bent against stamping out the church of Jesus Christ. I mean, he was responsible for the death of some of its early leaders. He would barge into the homes of Christians and take husbands and wives and children and drag them into prison where they would be beaten for their faith. And yet this hardened enemy of the cross one day was traveling down the Damascus Road, and there he met Jesus Christ, and his life was wonderfully transformed. And this one-time opponent of Christianity became its greatest proponent and yet its most powerful preacher, and we know him today as Paul the Apostle. And friends, I want you to know that Paul the Apostle is a reminder to us that when we by faith trust God, we can see that there is no person too hard for God to redeem. Because you see, God loves to save souls. I will say it this way. God's desire is for men to be saved. In fact, Jesus told us that. Remember in John chapter 12, Jesus made this statement. Jesus said, I did not come to judge the world, but I came to save the world. Jesus Christ came to seek sinners. He came to save the lost. John echoed those words when he said, in 1 John 2 and verse 12, Jesus said, and he, or John said, he, Jesus, is the propitiation for our sins. That's us. He is the propitiation of our sins, and not for ours only, but for the sins of the whole world. He didn't die just for the church. He died for the world. And listen, this is what makes good news good news. It means that we can walk up to anybody, anytime, anywhere, any situation, any circumstance in life, and we can say to that individual that God loves you, and Jesus Christ died for your sins. Friends, the good news isn't good news for some and bad news for others. It's good news for everybody who places their faith and their trust in Jesus Christ. And I want you to know something. When we by faith trust God, we'll soon discover that there is no person too hard to be redeemed. There is no one so sinful that God cannot save. There is no one beyond God's redeeming grace. Nobody is so blown it with God that God has cast them aside. Friends, there is salvation for all. There is forgiveness to anybody who comes to him in faith. And humanly speaking, if there was anybody who was beyond the long reach of redemption, it would have been a man by the name of Tas Sada. Maybe you know the name, maybe you don't. He wrote a book that's in a lot of our bookstores today. But Tas Sada was a killer. He'd killed Jews in Israel and Christians throughout the Middle East. In fact, he would oftentimes just drive by a known Christian's home and lob a hand grenade into the room and blow up the house, and sometimes just riddle that place with machine gun fire. He was known today as that modern Saul of Tarsus. In fact, he was far worse. His nickname was the Butcher, because that's exactly what he did. He would butcher anybody who did not believe his religious ideology. He was a sniper in the Palestinian Liberation Army. He once tried to assassinate an Arab crown prince. He was a bodyguard of Yasser Arafat. He was on a first-name basis with Osama bin Laden. This man was bad, and he had a hatred, a boiling hatred, for anybody who disagreed with his religious position. But in 1993, he was visiting an evangelical friend of his in the United States. This man began to share with Tas Sada the gospel, and on first hearing, he got under conviction. He believed in the redeeming love of Jesus, and there he bowed his knee, and he placed his faith and his trust in Jesus Christ, and he was radically born again. And he began to share the gospel with his family. His family got saved, and he was able to share the gospel with his former boss, Yasser Arafat, before he died in 2004. By the way, isn't that significant? We look at a guy like Yasser Arafat and we wonder, how is a guy like that ever going to be reached? You know why? You know what? God loved Yasser Arafat so much so that he allowed Tas Sada to be converted and to be able to go into his presence and to share the gospel with this man. God is getting his work done, because there are people around the world that are willing to trust God by faith Today, Tassad and his family serve God full-time, reaching people on the Gaza Strip and the West Bank. And every time, friends, we think of Tassad, we need to remember that our God is a God of infinite and unlimited power. And there is nobody, there is no person too hard for God to redeem. God can save you. God can save your family. God can save your relatives. God can save your loved ones if they will simply come to him in faith. Friends, when we by faith trust God, do you know what we'll soon discover? Yes, we will discover that there is no promise too hard to be realized. There is no problem too hard to be resolved. We'll discover that there's no prayer too hard to be revealed, and there is no person too hard to be redeemed. That's why John gave us these great words in 1 John 5 and verse 4. Listen to what he said. He said, "This is the victory that overcomes the world, our faith." It's faith in God. It's faith in a God who spoke all that we see and know into existence. It's faith in a God of infinite and unlimited power. It's faith in a God who knows every hair that is upon your head. He knows every hair that falls to the ground. He's a God that knows your situation, your circumstance. He's a God who knows your problems. He's a God who's desperately in love with you, and that God desires to show his power through your life. He wants to make his promises real. He wants to answer your prayer. He wants to solve your problems. He wants to bring your loved one to the foot of the cross where they bow in submission to him as Lord and Savior. But God waits for us. God waits for us to meet him through that simple choice of faith. Friends, may I say to you today, there's absolutely nothing, and I mean nothing, too hard for the Lord. Let's bow for prayer, shall we? With our heads bowed and our eyes closed. Lord, we thank you today that you're a God of infinite and unlimited power, and that there is absolutely nothing too difficult for you. And Lord, as we come to you today, we pray that you would give us an understanding of who you are and what you can do. Lord, I pray that you'd stir us and strengthen us in our faith, that we might trust you, that we might see you working in our lives, fulfilling your promises, solving our problems, answering our prayer, and Lord, redeeming those people that we know and those people that we love. Lord, stir us in our faith. Thank you that you are great and a mighty God. And we say with the prophet Jeremiah, "All Lord God, who made the heavens and the earth by your outstretched hand, Lord, we know that there's absolutely nothing too hard for you. Lord, meet our needs. Be glorified in and through our life. Bless your people. And we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen."